may seem like an odd pairing to you to have a Bach and Shostakovich in the same program a few hundred years apart, but you'll see there are actually a few more similarities in the structure and the model of the music, even if not the sound. But we start, or we end the semester, I should say, kind of the way we started. Very early in the semester, I think it was February 18, we had a department-wide project where we played not some of the Art of Fugue, but in fact the entire thing, all hour and 20 minutes of it. And Bach was a man of challenges. One day he just wanted to write a prelude and fugue on every major and minor key, so he did in the Waldenberg Clavier. In fact, he did it twice. And very late in his life, when the art of writing fugues was becoming out of fashion, obsolete, he decided to write the ultimate fugue and write not one and not three, but 18 fugues on the same subject, the Art of Fugue. We're not going to play the whole thing for you today, because we already did that earlier in the semester, but I thought we would play three little excerpts that were the contribution from this chamber music class into this department-wide project. So we will play without pause the counterpoints number 4, 14, and 17, and you can, if you so wish, applaud for all of us at the end of the three excerpts.
Thank you. Thank you.
fortunately him, wrote this specifically for String Quartet. And Shostakovich was in the middle of a project that he would not live to complete. Much like Bach in the Wilton Temple Clavier, he wanted to write a string quartet on every major and minor key. He kind of got more than halfway there. This is number 7. He got all the way to number 15 before he died. But no key actually repeats. So this is the only one, thankfully, in F sharp minor. In 1950, also meaningfully, it was, of course, the anniversary of Bach's death. He died in 1950. Shostakovich was so inspired by this icon of music that he wrote himself also a collection of preludes and fugues for all the major minor keys. So the parallels are more than might seem on the surface. This is a really very compact piece. It's 3 movements that are incredibly contrasting in only about 13, 14 minutes, so we're halfway there. And very meaningfully, the structures, the musical forms that Shostakovich is using are very tight and very ancient, things that have been around for a long time. It doesn't sound like old music. It's very dissonant, strident, sometimes violent. But the first movement is a sonata form, and the last movement is, guess what, a fugue, just like Bach had written.
Thank you. Thank you.